So today concept name is selenium life cycle. Very very important concept too. Here only we will discuss main important concept. Here only we will work with Excel file, everything very very important concept. This is the concept too. Maven framework also we can discuss in this concept only. So today concept name is selenium life cycle. This is what last class, right? Today concept is selenium life cycle. First theory part. After that, we will discuss. Today concept is selenium life cycle. Selenium life cycle contains six phases. Selenium life cycle contains six phases. One is test planning. Generating the basic test. Enhancing the test. Executing the test too. Debugging the test too. Analyzing the results. Selenium life cycle contains six phases: test planning, generating the basic test, enhancing the test, executing the test, debugging the test, analyzing the results. So actually this is the second concept. After property file only we need to discuss this this concept. But so in this concept we will use annotations. Annotations means if you want to implement data driven testing, or if you want to implement page object model framework, so that time we need annotations. So first of all, there's a reason we learned framework concepts, advanced concepts. So after that we are discussing this concept lastly. But actually this is the second concept. Actually this is the second concept. So first, test planning. First test planning. Wow. Selenium life cycle contains six phases. First phase, test planning. First one, test planning. So test plan document prepared by test lead. So there are six phases. Once again, I will write it here. Selenium life cycle. Today concept is Selenium life cycle. Selenium life cycle contains six phases. Vaishnavi madam.
Hello sir. Hi sir.
Hi madam. How are you?
Good sir. How are you?
Good madam. Today concept is Selenium life cycle madam. Selenium life cycle contains six phases. One is test planning. Generating the basic test. Enhancing the test. Executing the test. Analyzing the results. debugging the test. Next to debugging the test. Analyzing the results. Right. Test planning, generating the basic test, enhancing the test, executing the test, debugging the test, analyzing the results. Actually, test plan document prepared by test lead. Test lead will prepare the test plan document. First of all, test plan document, test plan, automation test plan document, automation test plan document prepared by automation test lead. First, he will understand the all the requirements very clearly. First of all, this test lead, he will understand the all the requirements very clearly. After understanding the requirements, what areas can be automated, what areas cannot be automated, he will observe what areas can be automated, what areas cannot be automated. Using automation tools also, we can't automate all the areas using tools also. Can you say any best example? Yes, using automation tool, we can't enter any single data or single character into Google search. So if you have doubt, once try it. Using Selenium WebDriver, we can't enter single character in Google search. So if you want to, normally, if you want any information, so just like where is my inquiry system, where is something. So if you want to know information, if you want to know anything, so first of all, we will go to Google search and we will enter the data. But using Selenium WebDriver, we can't automate all the areas. That means best example, Google search. So this is very, very important interview point. Once try it in your system, using Selenium WebDriver, we can't enter any single character into Google search field, right? So that's the reason we will observe what areas can be automated, what areas cannot be automated. So next, third point, you will analyze positive and negative flow of the application. Positive and negative flow of the application. Positive testing and negative testing. Negative, positive. Whenever you are giving positive inputs, so how it is responding. If you give negative inputs, so how it is responding. So that means you will analyze positive and negative flow of the application. And you will do scheduling. You will do scheduling. And he will do configurational settings. Configurational settings means if you want to work with Selenium, compulsory we need to configure some fields like Java need and Eclipse, Selenium WebDriver programs and PoI files. We need all those things. So he will do configurational settings. That is the test plan document. So right. Next, generating the basic test. Number of times we generated basic test. Number of times. So WebDriver WD equal new Firefox driver. WD.get.http.gmail.com or Facebook.com or YouTube.com. That is the sites. So number of times we wrote some code. So that is generating the basic test. Next, after writing the code, we execute a number of times. So execute the test also over and analyzing the results. After executing, so pass or fail, results is coming or not. So we will analyze the test. So these four concepts are already, these three concepts are also already over. Test plan document prepared by test lead, that is different. Next, debugging the test, I will tell you. Next concept, enhancing the test. Here after writing the script, we will do some changes to that particular script. That is called enhancement. So here enhancement phase, we will discuss some concepts. First one is assertions. Second, synchronization. Third, data-driven testing. In the data-driven testing, we will work with different files like web application and Excel file. Web application, Excel file and array. Data-driven testing, we will do three. One is web application, second one is Excel, third one is array. Next, data driven framework. Data driven framework. Next, POM, page object model framework. Next, Maven. These are the concepts we need to discuss. Assertions, synchronization, data driven testing. We will implement with web application, Excel, array, data driven framework, and POM, page object model framework, Maven. These are the concepts we need to discuss. So first concept, assertions. First concept to assertions. Assertions is nothing but it is a validation point or checkpoint. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. So if it is both are same, we can give the status pass, otherwise we can give the status fail. So that is the assertions concept. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. So first concept to assertions. Window show you Project Explorer. Go to SRC, take the new class. Class name is assertions. Keep the mark public static void menu. Click on finish. Now write the code. Web driver WD equal to, oh, what happened? WD equal to new Firefox driver. Web driver WD equal to new Firefox driver. WD dot get HTTP. cleartrip.com. I'm taking one site, new site, cleartrip.com. So import the statement. My Eclipse is very slow. What happened? Web driver, Firefox driver. God. Control Z. Okay, right. So we will compare the expected value with the actual value. For example, I'm taking one string. String. I'm taking one string. Wait. What happened to this one? String. Exp value. Exp val equal to Hyderabad, I'm giving string exp value equal to Hyderabad, I'm giving string actual value. I'm getting from application. I'm getting from application caps string act val equal to wd dot find element. By dot xpath, I'm giving some xpath So I'm giving XPath. Why it is playing with me? I'm giving XPath dot get attribute method, get attribute string actual value wd dot find element by dot XPath. Here we are using get attribute method. Dot get attribute. It not showing. Get attribute. So I'm taking any value property, name property, any property, whatever you want, you can take it. Okay, value property I'm taking. Next. SYSO control space. System dot out dot println. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. Exp value dot equals playing with me. What happened? Equals. ACT wall expected value equals actual value. So here we are using one ternary operator. So this is the ternary operator. Question mark is nothing but it is a ternary operator. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. This symbol is called ternary operator. Ternary operator. Ternary operator. So if it is both are same, it will give passed, otherwise it will give failed. Passed, pass, okay, or fail. One minute work, 1 minute concept. It is taking this much time. Pass or fail. Right. Go to cleartrip.com. Actually, I'm taking any XPath. Not sorry, value property. I want to take any value property. First to take the XPath. So round trip XPath I am taking. Round trip XPath I am taking. Actually, that property is round trip. Copy. First XPath give here. Next. See actual value property is round trip. Actually value property is round trip, but I gave Hyderabad. So automatically it will show you error. That means it will say fail. save, click on run. Now it will give fail. Actually, expected value I am expecting Hyderabad. Actual value is round trip, but I gave HOID. So both are not equal. So it will say you fail. Answer is once again run it. It is running once again. Number of times I clicked. Answer fail. So for example, if I give round trip value round trip only, control V. So now it will give show you pass. Save, click on run. Oh God, it's taking too much time. Now it will give pass. Now it will give pass. That is the assertions concept. We will compare the expected value with the actual value. If it is both are same, it will give true, otherwise it will give false. Now it will give status is pass. So that is the assertions concept. So that is assertions concept too. Okay, next concept to synchronization. Next concept is synchronization. Before going to synchronization, so my Java is playing with me. Actually, we can complete that concept in within 1 second, but it is very slow moving. So why it is slow? Start control panel. Where is the programs and features? If it is not working sometime, so then oh God, is updated. Install. Yes. Yes. Today, next concept name is synchronization. What is synchronization? Synchronization is nothing but it is a process of matching the speeds of both tool and the application. So synchronization is one of the concept. With example, I will tell you, it is very, very important concept. So synchronization is a process of matching the speeds of both tool and the application in order to keep them sync with each other to obtain proper testing results. So for example, Gmail application, after giving username, and if you click on next button, so it is taking some time. In between, we are writing thread or sleep. Okay, for example, in future also we got one application, so one page to another page it is moving. So how much time taking, we don't know. So that time we are writing thread or sleep 10 seconds, 10,000 seconds, milliseconds means 10 seconds. If you write to 10 seconds, so compulsory tool will wait 10 seconds. Tool compulsory, it will wait 10 seconds. If it is next page available or invoke, so but Selenium will not perform the operation. Why? Because we gave wait 10 seconds. Compulsory, it will wait 10 seconds. That is the main drawback in wait statement. Okay, what is the main drawback in wait statements? If you give wait, so compulsory it will wait 10 seconds. If it is application available also, it will wait 10 seconds. If it is application available also, it will wait 10 seconds. So with example, I will tell you gmail.com. I am going to Gmail page. Still it is slow. Why it is doing like this? WD dot find element. Is there any space problem? No, can I change the work location? Copy file. D colon. Click on OK. Synchronization is a process of matching the speeds of both tool and the application in order to keep them sync with each other to obtain proper testing results. So just example, first I am taking one Gmail application. So what is the main drawback in wait statement? If you give 10 seconds compulsory, it will wait 10 seconds. So if you give 100 seconds, so it will wait 100 seconds. If it is application available also, it will not perform any actions on the application. So that is the main drawback. So that is the reason. So we will use synchronization point to take the new project general Java project. Click on next to. Project name is 9 AM. Click on finish. Configure Selenium web driver programs. Right click. Oh God. Uninstalled, I installed freshly, but still it is. Java is not responding. Right click. Properties. Java build path. Libraries. Add external jars. Go to desktop. Oh God. My system is very fast actually. But what happened? Control all, click on open, click on OK. Right. Here also it is slow. Just wait, please, please cooperate with me, please. What happened to my system file? Switch to workspace. 11 AM. What is the time now?
10:25.
10:20. మేడం అది సుచరిత గారు మీది కూడా యూకేనే కదా లేరా మహాశివరాత్రి ఎప్పుడు అయిపోయిందా ఇంకొక పైసి
అయిపోయింది సార్
Okay, go to SRC. Take the new class Synku. Keep the mark public start requirement. Click on finish. Wait, wait, 1 second. Synchronization, best example, very, very important concept. So web driver WD equal new Firefox driver. In between, I am writing thread.sleep. In between, I am writing thread.sleep. Observe carefully. So if I write thread.sleep, compulsory it will wait. Here I am writing 20 seconds. 20 seconds I am writing. So if it is application available also, it will wait 20 seconds. So that is the main drawback of wait statement. I am going to Gmail site only. So number of times we worked with Gmail site. So right now, synchronization concept. In the synchronization means, so it is a process of matching the speeds of both tool and the application in order to keep them sync with each other to obtain proper testing results. So synchronization main concept aim is, so sometimes whenever you are working with the new application, that time we don't know how much time taking to load a page. In that situation, if you give thread or sleep, compulsory it will wait 20 seconds. If you give 10 seconds, it will wait 10 seconds. If you give 100 seconds, it will give 100 seconds. That is the main drawback. That is the main drawback. So that's the reason, instead of wait statement, we will use synchronization point. Here is time waste. Wait is time waste. Why because so if you write 20 seconds, it will wait to 20 seconds. If it is application available also, it will wait 20 seconds. So that is the main drawback. That is the main drawback. So that is the reason we will use synchronization point. We will use synchronization point. If I click run, if it is application available within 2 seconds only, but it will wait 20 seconds. See, after it will give username, it will click on next button. It will wait 20 seconds. It will wait 20 seconds. Right, that is the drawback of wait statement. So we will use synchronization point. So synchronization point statement, instead of wait statement, we will use synchronization point. So here we are giving 20 seconds, but it will not wait 20 seconds. If it is application available, it can perform the action. So here I 30 seconds I am giving. Here I am giving 30 seconds. WD dot manage dot timeouts dot implicit wait 30 seconds I am giving. So it will wait up to not 30 seconds. So if it is application available, it can perform the action. That is the use of synchronization point. So wait statement, what is the main drawback? If you write wait statement, specified time, how much time you specified, that much time it will wait. But synchronization point is just not like that. So if it is application available, it can perform the action. See the difference between both. See, it will not wait to observe. This is the last concept today. My system is playing with me. I don't have that much patience. Yes, see, it performed. So that is the use of synchronization point. So I mentioned 30 seconds, but it is not waiting 30 seconds. If it is application available, it can perform the action. That is the use of synchronization.